टुडे आई विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट सब अरेक्नॉइड हेमरेज और SAH. डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द सर्कुलेशन ऑफ CSF फ्लूइड इन ब्रीफ, इट इज प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय द कोरोइडल प्लेक्सस इन द लैटरल वेंट्रिकल्स विच गोज इनटू द थर्ड एंड फोर्थ वेंट्रिकल्स, देन इट गोज इनटू द सब अरेक्नॉइड स्पेस एंड बेसिकली इट इज एब्सॉर्ब्ड इन द अरेक्नॉइड ग्रैनुलेशन टिश्यू एंड इट ड्रेन्स इनटू द सजाइटल साइनस. टॉकिंग अबाउट डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ ब्रेन हेमरेज, first one is the epidural hematoma with where there is bleeding outside the dura mater. Subdural is below the dura mater. Subarachnoid space is below the arachnoid mater where CSF lies usually. And the fourth one is intracerebral hemorrhage, which is bleeding into the brain parenchymal tissue. So subarachnoid hemorrhage. Subarachnoid hemorrhage comprises of bleeding into the subarachnoid space containing CSF surrounding the brain and spinal cord. The most common etiology is trauma and second is Berry's aneurysmal rupture. So risk factors associated with certain conditions for intracranial aneurysm, one is ADPKD, that is autosomal dominant inherited polycystic kidney disease, Ehlers-Danlos syndrome, vascular type 4, Moyamoya syndrome, alpha 1 antitrypsin deficiency, SLE, fungal infections, pheochromocytoma and AV malformations. The behavioral risk factor for aneurysmal rupture include hypertension, cigarette smoking, heavy alcohol intake, and use of sympathomimetic drugs like cocaine. So, basically, classification of intracranial aneurysm by morphology, there are three types, that is saccular, fusiform, and dissecting. Saccular is like this. This is the artery, like this. Fusiform is simple, it's like this. Pardon my drawing, okay? And dissecting means, it is dissection, means this is the aneurysm, right? And blood will flow through the wall of the aneurysm, like this. Similar in case, what happens in case of aortic dissection. A brief revision of circle of Willis, because it's very important, it asked many times. So the vertebral artery will join together to form the basilar artery. The basilar artery will divide into the two branches, known as posterior cerebral artery, right? Now the internal carotid artery will give MCA and ACA, that is middle cerebral artery and anterior cerebral artery. Both the anterior cerebral artery are connected by anterior communicating artery. The middle cerebral artery and the posterior cerebral artery are connected by posterior communicating artery. So this is basically forms the summary of blood supply of brain, which is also the base known as circle of Willis. So thunderclap headache, aneurysmal rupture results in sudden onset of severe headache. The patient will usually describe this as the worst headache of his life. In 80% of the cases, there might be associated with other symptoms, mostly of raised ICT or meningism. These are nausea and vomiting, neck stiffness, photophobia, brief LOC, loss of consciousness, focal neurological deficit, including cranial nerve palsies. Certain focal neural focal physical findings are present in associated with subarachnoid hemorrhage. These are third nerve palsy, sixth nerve palsy, combination of hemiparesis and aphasia, or visuospatial neglect, bilateral leg weakness, ophthalmoplegia, unilateral visual loss or bitemporal hemianopia, impaired level of consciousness and impaired upward gaze, brainstem signs, neck stiffness, retinal and subhyaloid hemorrhages and periretinal hemorrhages. Hunt and Hess scale for subarachnoid hemorrhage. Grade 0 is asymptomatic. Grade 1 is mild headache and mild nuchal rigidity. No neurological deficit. Grade 2 is moderate to severe headache, but no neurological deficit other than cranial nerve palsy. Grade 3 is drowsy, confused, or mild focal deficit. Grade 4 is stupor, moderate to severe hemiparesis, and early decerebrate posturing. Grade 5 is deep comatose and decerebrate posturing. There is WFNS scale, that is World Federation of Neurological Surgeons, Glasgow Coma Scale. So it is just important to remember the name of this they have asked. This Hess and Hunt scale, they usually ask the grading. So there are four major causes of delayed neurological deficits, which is re-rupture. Re-rupture means what? After the aneurysm is coiled or clipped, right? Because of raised blood pressure, there might be re-rupture of the aneurysm. Hydrocephalus, the blood particles, if the bleeding is more or the bleeding is more in the subarachnoid space, it may cause obstruction of the arachnoid villi and cause obstructing hydrocephalus. Delayed cerebral ischemia and hyponatremia. Hyponatremia in subarachnoid hemorrhage is usually due to syndrome of inappropriate ADH secretion, that is SIADH. So this is a CT scan scale known as Fisher scale. You should know that Fisher scale is for subarachnoid bleed and it depends on the CT scan. Questions have been asked on this, so I'm covering it over here. Group 1 is no blood detected. Group 2 is diffuse deposition or a thin layer of blood with all vertical layers of blood, right? Group 3 is localized clots or vertical layer of blood 1 mm or greater in thickness. Group 4 is diffuse or no subarachnoid hemorrhage, intraparenchymal or interventricular clots. So the lumbar puncture in CSF examination, there is bleed in the subarachnoid space. So it's obvious that there will be increase in the RBC count. There will be xanthochromia. Xanthochromia means there is yellowish discoloration of the CSF fluid. Now why there is this yellowish discoloration is, there is lysis of the red blood cells and subsequent conversion of hemoglobin to bilirubin, which stains the CSF fluid within 6 to 12 hours. So it takes at least 6 to 12 hours for the CSF to stain yellow. So if the CSF is yellow, it means that the bleeding has occurred 6 to 12 hours before. The xanthochromic spinal fluid usually peaks in intensity and remains for around 1 to 4 weeks, depends on the amount of subarachnoid bleed. So treatment of subarachnoid hemorrhage is mostly surgical and it's an emergency. Aneurysm can be clipped or coiled. Coiling is done by endoscopy. Clipping is done by a neurosurgeon. Surgical repair involves placing a metal clip across the aneurysm neck, thereby eliminating the risk of re-bleeding. So now what exactly happening is, imagine that this is the aneurysm. Okay, here is the bleeding. So the blood flow is in this direction. So they'll place a metal clip over here so that it will eliminate the chances of re-bleeding. So coming to the medical management of subarachnoid hemorrhage, in case of subarachnoid hemorrhage, the GCS of the patient is very low. So it is very important to protect the airway. It is very important to manage the blood pressure before and after aneurysm treatment, because it will, if BP is very high, it will increase the chances of re-bleed. Then it is very important to manage vasospasm. Treatment of hyponatremia. Hyponatremia is mostly due to SIADH in case of subarachnoid hemorrhage. Limiting the secondary brain insults and preventing the pulmonary embolus.